Hi everyone, welcome to the Acic and Milestone webinar. Your speakers for today will be me, Davide Schiavon. I'm the community manager for Southern Europe. I will introduce Milestone during 10 minutes, and then Alexis Delamine, Acic trainer, will present the fantastic solution from Acic. Please join us at LinkedIn. We post every day new technologies, new integration, and a lot of useful information. So you can scan the QR code or follow us with Beyond Security, Make the World See, Milestone Paladin, or just with at Milestone System. A quick introduction about Milestone. We are present in 150 countries with more than 800 employees, and we are integrated with 1,800 solution partners. We have 9,000 cameras supported today, and we have a very nice news for you. We are going to discuss later about how we are going to increment this number. And then we have plus 10,000 reseller and integrators all around the world with more than 150,000 installations done. Milestone is a global VMS platform leader. We have actually 5 versions where each version has the same software core, but they have different functionalities. And what is important in the story is that performance and security are the same for all the versions. The good news is that our partner Acic is compatible, and it can work with Express Plus, Professional Plus, Expert, and Corporate. The role of the Milestone Open Platform VMS in the end customer solution stack is to be in between of the application stack made by video analytics, artificial intelligence, access control, building management, SIM and traffic management, and the hardware stack made by cameras, IoT devices, servers, workstations, storage, and network. His role is to combine application stack, VMS, and hardware stack to work together in order to answer to new market challenges. The Milestone community solutions are the answer to the new market challenges. The community solutions work with our technology partners, and they are fully integrated with XProtect Smart Client, XProtect Management Client, XProtect Mobile Client. They use open API from Milestone in order to increment the number of functionalities and create new features or new solutions. Once the development is done, Milestone verify and certify those applications. You can easily explore inside Marketplace or the community solution, as well servers, hardwares, applications, IoT, recorders, and a lot of other devices that can be easily integrated and verified by Milestone. Let's have a look about the device supported by Milestone. We say that today we support more than 9,000 devices, but what we can do today in order to better answer to the market request. Starting from the version 2019, Milestone will introduce the driver framework. Now, all the developers can develop their own driver to have a deeper integration. It means that if you don't want to use the standard ONVIF driver and you want to go beyond the capabilities, you can now develop your driver for your device. This will help to have a faster response to the market needs. All those devices from the hardware stack and the application from the application stack can work together using the rules engine. Rule engine use device events to trigger actions. Let me show you an easy example. Imagine we have ASIC installed inside a camera that detects somebody cross above the fence. The alarm is sent to the rule engine, who will detect the alarm and will send it to our feature, our Audio Edge. Audio Edge then will send a pre-recorded message to a speaker where you can say you are in a forbidden area, please go away. The last feature I will show to you today is the centralized search, a feature from the smart client. This feature will centralize all the search activity in one place. Now you will have the search tab in smart client where you can look for sequences, alarms, events, bookmarks, and motion in one place. What is very nice is now you can search data from the integrated solutions. It means you can, if you look for ASIC alarm on multi-camera, you can do it from one place. What is very important, this feature will allow you to work faster and more efficiently. Thank you for the attention, and now I will hand over the presentation to Alexis, who will introduce you all the advantages of the ASIC Milestone integration.
Thank you, Davide, for this introduction. So here the presentation will be split in two parts. The first part with some slides to present you ASIC and the products, the analytics product that we have. And then the second part will be more for a demonstration of some scenario, detection scenario, some context, and also the integration with Milestone. So first of all, a brief history of ASICs. It started in the early 90s with the Université Catholique de Louvain in Belgium. So the first algorithms for image processing started there. Then in 2001, with the research center Multitel and with still the university, the Department of Image Processing was created. And it's in 2003 that ASIC was launched to exploit the research initially conducted by Multitel Center. Today, we are about 10 persons with a turnover of 1.3 million euros. We have installations and partners all over the world. So in Middle East, in Africa, Europe, of course, and so on. All the expertise is in the company. All the development, the software are done internally. And we have a continuous innovation. So we participate to research projects, European research project, Belgian research project, to have to evolve with our products, to improve our products. So about the solutions, we have two versions, a server solution and edge solutions that can be installed on the Axis or Hikvision camera, and the server solutions can be installed through a virtual machine or natively on the server. And so we are, of course, integrated with Milestone since 2011. Sorry. The architecture, a bit more details about the architecture. So we have on the left the video analytics on server or on the edge cameras or with video encoders, with compatible video encoders, you can also install the application. And on the other side, through the network, we send the events, the videos, the metadata for the overlays, and we can activate I/O modules, Modbus, and of course, send events to Milestone XProtect. So now for some brief introduction of our products. So this is here all the product categories that we have. The main product is activity detection for perimeter detection, perimeter protection, but also for smart cities. Auto tracking, which is also for intrusion detection by controlling a PTZ camera to follow the target. Panorama detection, which is more like a radar but with a thermal imaging. Counting solutions with people counting and crowd numbering. Traffic monitoring for traffic surveillance, traffic vehicle counting, and so on. And finally, license plate recognition. So more details about the products. Activity detection, it features fence, line crossing, tripwire, of course, for the perimeter protection. So the detection of the crossing of virtual lines, and you can also filter with the direction of the crossing. Sterile zone, intrusion in the zone, no man's land. Stationary detection, left or removed object. So you can detect a stationary vehicle parked on the street, stolen object in a museum, or left back in transport context. Graffiti too. Loitering, so if someone stays too long in a region. Group detection with the classification of the group size. People running. So you can adjust speeds to detect only people or vehicle over speeding, and counter flow to detect wrong ways. So activity detection has three versions. The full package is activity detection, and we have package dedicated only to perimeter protection, which is zone detection, and stillness detection, which is more dedicated to abandoned or stolen objects. Next, we have auto tracking. So like I said, it's also for the intrusion of a person or vehicle, and we can track autonomously and continuously the target after the first detection. So we can take control of the PTZ camera to follow the target for a while, and it can be triggered by external signal with an API or coupled with activity detection. So typically we can have a fixed camera, a thermal camera, watching the fence, and when there is a detection, it's detected by the fixed camera, and then for example through Milestone XProtect you can send a PTZ camera to the location of the detection and start the auto tracking to follow the target after it leaves the field of view of the fixed camera. So it can help the operator to know where the intruder is going after having crossed the fence. Panorama detection, so like I said, it's a bit like a radar but with thermal imaging, so also for intrusion for person or vehicle, and we also have tracking, autonomous and continuous. So this is with thermal imaging on a turret, and with the continuous sweeping of the turret to film the right areas, so up to 360 degrees. So it's suited for seaside, borders, airports, and we can send, when there is a detection, we can send the location of the target. Counting solution with people counting and crowd numbering. So people counting in and out counting of visitors for shops, for example. Area numbering. To have an estimation of the density in an area, you can define multiple areas per cameras. Occupancy rates, so you can define a maximum allowed density and compare the rate, the current rate, to that maximum. So you can receive alerts when there is when the occupancy reaches a critical or warning threshold. So you can send. You can adjust and be proactive when there is too many people in an area. For example, if you are watching a station in in the train station, and there is too many people on the station, you can dispatch more trains to have to adjust to the situation. And there is also a report interface with a dashboard, tables, and graphs, so you can retrieve statistics about the countings and the density, the numbering. Traffic monitoring for statistics, but also for detection. So statistics about the counting of vehicles, speed measurement, vehicle classification. So you can count how many cars, how many trucks, and so on. Traffic classification, if it's quiet, free flow, busy, or congested, you can have alerts about this classification. And also automatic incident detection, speed drop, congested traffic detection, stopped vehicle, ghost driver, overspeed detection, and abnormal speed drop detection. And lastly, you have also a flow monitoring feature for traffic flow statistics. So before going to the markets, I'd like to, so we can switch to some demonstration. So here I will first launch a video demo of Panorama. So Panorama detection, like you can see here, you have on the left, top left, the current image of the thermal camera. On the bottom, you have the reconstructed panoramic image. And on the right, you have like a radar, you can upload on the system a map of the area that is being watched. And you have in blue the whole area being watched, and in yellow the current area being filmed by the camera. When there is a detection, like here, you can display on the map the position of the target, and the application takes control of the camera to follow the target for a while. And after it's out of the range, or if after a while it will stop following and resume the sweeping and the surveillance. And when there is a detection, we can of course send the GPS coordinates of the targets to know exactly where it is. So with this kind of application, we can cover up to 800 meters or 1 kilometer range, depending on the optics of the thermal camera. Okay, so here I'm gonna show you the configuration of a whole analytics streams. So we first connect to the analytics server here, just typing the IP address of the server on a web browser. And then on this system page, we can select which stream we want to work on and configure the acquisition of a video stream. So here we will take a video directly from Milestone. So if we can connect to Milestone, and we can input the IP address of the Milestone server. And then once we are connected with the credentials of Milestone, we have here the list of all the cameras that are already installed and listed in Milestone, and we can select the ones we want. And here we have the confirmation of the acquisition with the live image on the left. So here it's a PTZ camera. So I can go back to the smart client and go to a preset where I want to configure the analytics. So with PTZ camera, we can have analytics on presets. So for each preset, it will detect the position of the camera and load the corresponding configuration for that preset. So here we have the configuration tool with the live view and then the settings. And if we go to settings in the PTZ toolbox, we can name the configuration for that preset. So we name it like the preset named on the camera itself in XProtect. And first we have to configure the calibration of the view. So to have a good estimation of the size of the object, the speeds, the length, and so on. So here we can just use information on the screen, like the fence here, to draw the measurements. But we can also have ask someone to go in the field of view and go at different location in the image to take the measurements. And a last segment on the ground, also for the perspective or the view. Here we will configure intrusion scenario for someone going to the fence here, so we can create a region of interest and then line crossing, and the target will have to go to the region of interest and then cross the two lines to be detected. So here we can create the class that we want to detect. So here it's a person with a predefined minimum and maximum speed. And once we have configured the target and the region and the lines, we can link all of them with the rules here. So presence in a region of the person in the region number one. And I will create a second rule for the crossing of the two lines. So it's a sequence of crossing of multiple lines. So again, I select the target and the sequence of the lines that the target has to cross to be detected. So since here we want to detect someone going to the fence, the first line to cross is line number two and then line number one. So finally, I can, in the display settings, I can show the calibration just to check that it's coherent with the scene and that there is not too much error. So we can see the segments in the calibration grid. So this is some tools to be sure that the calibration is good. Otherwise, it will not evaluate correctly the size of the objects. And once it's okay, I can just disable this display. So that's it for this configuration for this preset. I can switch to another preset and configure another context detection analytics context. And so here for it's already configured, and the scenario is to detect a stopped vehicle on the road. And we all have also configured through Milestone so that the PTZ will zoom in where the detection occurs. So here it's a stopped vehicle with the event ASIC stationary detection. For this preset. So normally when the car will enter the zone and will remain stationary for at least 20 seconds, there will be a detection, and the detection will be triggered to Milestone. For the integration, you just have to install the Milestone plugin here and enter the IP address of the analytics servers here so that Milestone can communicate with the ASIC server and which receive the events and the overlays. Then you have to create the analytics event, or it's already created here. So we have created a presence in a region with ASIC activity detection. So this is the name of the event that will be triggered by the server and that will be sent to the Milestone exported server. And then you just have to create the alarms triggered by the analytic events that we have created. So the crossing detection for the fence, the stopped vehicle on the road, and the presence also on the fence. So now I will ask my colleague to go to the area with his vehicle and stop there. So you will see the detection and the camera will be zooming in at the location of the detection. So here, this is the car coming in inside the area. And after 30 seconds, you will see the detection with the red box around the car, and the events will be shown on the bottom part of the screen. There you have the detection. It's appeared in the alarm list and the camera zoomed in on the detection. So you can, for example, do a license plate recondition there to have the license plate of the person that's parked there. And once after 20 seconds or so, it will switch back to the presets for the next detection and to continue the analytics on the context. Now I can switch to the other presets that we just configured. And so my colleague will simulate an intrusion and go to the fence. So you will see the detection first of the presence in the region, in the blue area. And then you will see the detection after he has crossed the two lines, the detection of the crossing. So with this kind of analytics on preset with PTZ camera, you can define context configuration for any presets that you want. If you have 10, 20, 50 presets on the camera, you can configure that amount of context analytics configuration for each presets. So you can see here, the alarms came up in Milestone. We see the red box of the target being detected, and then he's going back. So that's it for that kind of context and the integration with Milestone. The next thing I want to show you is the analytics on edge. So here I have an Acic camera, so I can access directly with the, if you have installed the Acic optimizer, you can access directly to the configuration of the analytics through the Milestone XProtect management client. So that's what I'm doing here. Select the camera that I want to configure, and in the app tab, you can see the application that's already installed here. So to install it, you just have to click add, select the package, and you can download the package on our website, and you just select it and upload it to the camera. Once it's installed, you just have to install also the license, so you will receive license code from Acic that you can upload there. Once the license is installed, you can start the application, and then in the applications tab, you can see here all the interface of the Edge application with the status page, with the live view of the analytics, and in the configuration tab, you can open the configuration tool, and it's the same as the configuration tool with the server version. So here I will configure a context for to detect abandoned bag, and I want to filter to detect only bags but not other kind of objects. So again, I'm doing the calibration first with some elements of measurements in the image. And with activity detection, we are using artificial intelligence, so with neural networks, to have more robustness on the detection with a second phase of the confirmation with this artificial intelligence service. And it's compatible with the Edge or the server version. So here I can configure a region of interest where I want to detect the stationary object. And then I can create an object class like a luggage, and I can create a custom object with some large minimum and maximum size, and I will I can take as large as I want, and I can use the neural network service to filter the objects that I don't want. So we can check here in the rule, the detection rule, we can select the stationary object rule with the object that we just created in the region. And then we can use the DNN, so the neural network service, to confirm only if it's a luggage. And we can also do it for any kind of objects. So for specific context, that kind of second confirmation will allow you to have a more robust detection for complex scenarios. So again, I'm checking the calibration if everything is correct so that the sizes will be correctly evaluated. So once I'm done, if I have installed the application on the camera, I have to also refresh the plugin configuration so that it knows that there is some intelligence, some edge application on the camera, so that it will correctly receive the events and the overlays from the camera. So this is the purpose of this button. And then I save again the configuration so it will correctly receive the event. And again, the analytics event have to be created to receive the event, so stationary detection for that kind of scenario, and the alarm triggered by this analytic event, ASIC left bag, and the source will be the camera that we just configured. Now if I switch to the live view, and I can put a bag in the area, and so we will see that the bag will be detected after 20 seconds, so that the delay can be configured depending on the context and how quickly you want to detect the stationary object. So here we have the red box around the object, and the detection appears in Milestone in the smart client. Next, I'm gonna move the back a bit away, and I will also put the chair on the area. And so you will see that the chair will be analyzed, but with the neural network service, it will be filtered because I don't want to detect chairs, but I only want to detect baggage, luggage like suitcase or handbags and so on, backpacks. So you will see here the red box around the bag, and an orange box because it's confirmed by the analytics, the classic analytics, but then it will be discarded by the neural network because it's detected as a chair and not as a bag. So this is that kind of application that we will use for the trash management context and scenarios that will be presented later this year. Of course, we saw in the Edge application, it was in French. Of course, it also exists in English. The next thing I wanted to show you is the replay. So if you are doing playback in the smart client, you can also do playback with the overlays of the time of the playback. So it allows you to directly see and understand what happened when there is a detection, because you will directly see the box around the object and the tracking of the object. So it's useful to troubleshoot and check what was detected and how it was detected. So that kind of overlays are recorded as long as the video exists in Milestone in the recordings. Okay, so that's all I wanted to show you for the detection context. Another thing I wanted to show you is for the counting applications. We have the dashboard, like I showed you in the slides. And so this is some kind of widgets that you can configure in Milestone. So like here, we have a map of a station, and we can define different zones where we are doing the counting, and it will be refreshed. And so you have an overview of the countings and the number, the density on each station on the map. You have also different kind of views. So here we have a map of the station, but we also can see graphics over time of the countings of the people for each station. Another kind of context here with different layouts. So here we have another layout with the map, just with the image of the station being monitored, and you have a direct overview of the countings on each zone of the station, And you also have the graphs and the live view here with the chord numbering running for this context. We also have another kind of display. So here we have a whole area, the whole station, and the different station being monitored for the countings. And here the graphs with per hour, the amount of people that were on the station per hour. So if it's red, there is more people and so on. And you can, of course, export those data to have more statistics and so on. So the last thing I want to show you, so maybe you saw that the Milestone Exportex version that's running is the latest one with the search function. So here with the search function, I can directly select on a camera the event that I want to see. So if I select here the event, it will select automatically the sequence where the event occurred. And if I select one of them and I choose to view it, here I will view it with the overlays and directly see with the box the detection that caused the event and the alarm. So that's it for the demonstration. Just to finish with the slides and the markets. So what kind of markets you can address with the different solutions that we have? You have the government with military, police, border control, and with some reference with the Kuwait police, the jail in Lebanon, the Molenbeek police, industry with nuclear, petrochemical, oil and gas, health. So some references are Janssen's Pharma, Airbus Helicopters in France, or Total in Fleury in Belgium. Transportation, airports, railways, maritime, roads, of course. So some references are with the Dubai airport, where we have installed the auto tracking on the perimeter of the airport. Casablanca airport, SNCF with the RER B and C, where they are using our chrome numbering solution on more than 700 video streams. Retail with malls, shops, data analytics. So we have some malls like Kane Kortrijk, shops with the Phone House, Maniac Luxus, and finally smart cities for road monitoring, parking management, security supervision. And some cities, some reference for the cities are Montbéliard, Nice, or La Louvière. Finally, some the competitive advantages. So technically, we have a redundancy that can be customized. Processing capacity. So like I said, with the project with SNCF, we have more than 700 cameras being analyzed on 4 servers. And you have also the option of centralized configuration and backup, whether it is on server or on edge. There is a tool that will allow you to retrieve and update the configuration of all the edge application. Integration, so we have an open API, multi-platform, with many support protocols supported for the video domain. Customization. So when there is specific needs, we can do some custom developments and start from the application and customize it depending of what is needed, required for the project. And of course, services with pre-sales, proof of concept, site surveys, commissioning, training for the partners, and of course, the support. Thank you for your attention. You have here all the contact if you have any questions regarding our products or your ongoing projects. Thank you.